Welcome back, guys, another episode of J-Hook Fishing. We have bought us a new camper, a 2021 Solaire made by Palomino. It is a 258 RBSS, that stands for Rear Bath Super Slide. Now, a lot of these tours that you see on YouTube is whenever they are completely empty, whenever the people do the tours of their campers. However, we have lived in this one. When I say lived, we're on a pretty big trip, a 3-week long trip across the country. So you're gonna see what it looks like as four adults and one child, 1 8-year-old, have lived in it for about, let's see, I think today is about day 8. And we are at Glacier National Park. You can see off in the distance the beautiful scenery that is here. But let's see here, we'll start at the back of the camper and we'll make our way around. I'll tell you some things that we like about it and things we don't like. One thing that we did like is that it had a spot for a hitch on the back. We have our bike rack on there now. The spare tire is mounted to the bike and we have our ladder on the side right here, mounted to the back bumper in case we need to get up and blow off any leaves on the slide out back there. It does have a ladder going up to the top so you can do your roof inspection about 2 or 3 times a year. So far we haven't had any issues with the bike carrier. We're probably gonna get a different bike carrier than this one. This one's just carrying the kids' bike for right now. Move around to the side, it does have a little outdoor kitchen area. Has an outdoor fridge. It's got some drinks and some goodies in there. It's got a couple of drawers for storage right here. Like I said, it's not going to be empty. You can see how we're storing our stuff in it. Has an outdoor sink. It does have an induction cooktopware that we've used. We've really liked it. But you have to use special cookware. It has to be induction. Pan or pot there, make sure it's magnetized and it will work. Another neat feature is that it has these lights here, but they can be set to motion sensor, and that's what this is here, is a motion sensor. So that's pretty neat. I think that's it for the outdoor area back here. We'll shut this, we'll keep on working our way around while we're here. It does have a power stabilizer jacks. The ones that we had, the camper we bought has that, so that's super nice. And it just powers down and powers up. And from best we can tell, it does not rock. Another feature that I liked about this camper is this storage here. I've converted into a rod locker. So it goes from here all the way up to the top. I don't know if you guys can see it with the light in there or not. But the longest rods I can get in there is my 6'6" rods. So if you're into fishing, this could be a good camper for you. I bought these little rod holders right here and just velcroed it onto the back and down on the floor right there. I don't know if you can see it or not. And so I've got 6 rods in there comfortably right now. I bought these little clips right here so we can store a vacuum out here. That's done a really good job. And the same thing with our broom as well on this side. So that's a neat little feature on the outside. Good little storage spot for it. Here in the middle, we have 2 outdoor speakers that can be hooked up to Bluetooth. We have your cable that will go for the TV right here. Apparently, there was supposed to be an outdoor mount that came with the camper. It did not come with ours, so we're waiting to get it from the place we bought it from. And it has 2 110 outlets right there, if you can see upside down. Has the awning. The awning's in right now. I'm not really using it. The lights are on for whatever reason. One thing that we not too thrilled about is this storage here. It does not go all the way through, but we have it set up so it can hold what we need it to hold. And it does have another little light here that you can set for motion sensor as well. It has a light switch here that turns on and off the lights on the front. And you really can't tell in daylight, but in dark time, this right here lights up with blue Solaire lights. And these little LED blue lights right here as well. Everything basic that comes with a camper, battery box, two tanks, power jack up and down. Nothing special here. And in here, let's unlock it. So here is where you can hook up your outdoor water hose right here. It came with it. It hooks up right there. And then you have all sorts of options here. If you're doing dry camping, you can turn on the water pump inside and you set this little configuration like this, white down, green up, red up, and blue pointing to the left. Your power fill tank, that's if you're filling up your city inlet to the tank. If you got it hooked up to city water, which is what we do, this is the configuration that we have it set up to. If you go to winterize it, you set it that configuration, and if you want to sanitize it, you can do that as well. Turn on the water pump here in case you're dry camping. This is where you hook up your satellite and your cable in here, and it all runs up through this little spot right here. Okay, so that's something new for us. We're a little, I guess, indifferent on that right now. See if there's anything we like or don't like about it. There is two outdoor things for the sewage to go through. This is a gray tank. It's called a galley tank. So this one is the kitchen sink only. And then back here in the back, this is the other gray tank and the black tank. Power outlet, and you have another little outdoor light here for whenever you're setting up in the dark. Another storage here is where we have some chairs that we're storing in there. So I guess one drawback on this one is the outdoor storage, but it has plenty of indoor storage. So we'll go in toward the inside and we'll check you out in there. All right, as we make our way inside, I think this is how they're doing a lot of campers these days, but this is our first time having steps like this. Pull a little notch, see if I can do it one hand. And these little legs go down, set it to whatever setting you want so that it's flush on the ground. And there you are. So as we come in, this one was pre-rigged for internet. It has its own router inside. We're not going to use it because we just use the Wi-Fi off our phone. Have your little control center here. You can check your battery, check your freshwater tank. We don't travel with water in ours. You can track the check the level of your black water, your gray tank one and your gray tank two. This is how you put your awning in and out, the water pump in case you're doing dry docking, water heater we have on, and then it does have underbelly tank heaters that it will heat the underbelly in case you are in super cold weather and nothing won't freeze in there. Here's the awning lights, what's been on, living room lights, and letting in your slide in and out. I have two storages here. Like I said, we have four adults, so this is where my mom and daddy has been keeping their clothes. They converted this into storage for their clothes, and there's their dirty clothes down there. As you come on in, there's another storage here that we've converted into a pantry, and a little bit more pantry area here. So the RB stands for rear bath, so we'll go into the bath. It's got its own door here. In here is where the massive amount of storage is. There's me. You know, there's storage back behind there. In here, storage, it's really deep, goes all the way to the back. We really haven't formulated a plan yet of what we're going to keep in there. Storage underneath the sink and three drawers here. And then this was, you know, a good selling point for us. This is a massive amount of storage in here. So I don't know if the light's going to help, maybe a little bit, but it goes all the way back to that back wall back there. This is right above that outdoor area. Shower here we've used. We have this little panel off here because it wasn't sealed around the drain, and so we had a little bit of a leak, but we've sealed it up and we've used it once and it hasn't leaked yet. So just another little review, something to look for if you buy, I guess, any camper, but something specifically in this one. All right, as we make our way in here, we'll start here and we'll work our way around. So up here, another little pantry we've converted into it. I guess you just had to figure out what works for you. It came with this TV. It does extend out and fold. Another little storage here. Let's see if we can get the fireplace going. It came with a remote. Look there, power. There's your power. There's your, maybe we can get the flames going so you can see it. There you go. We did use it for the first time. Shut this door so you guys can see a little better. Heave. Did use it last night since we are in right outside of Glacier National Park. It blows out the hot air right there. But we can turn that off for right now. So that's a neat little feature. Let's turn on the lights. It does have a big fridge here that we've liked. The microwave, we're not too tickled on it. The few times we've used it, it has really heated up some one part of the food and left the other part cold. It does rotate around, but so be it. Light and fan, it's got a little oven. This was, we've had a lot of campers, and with this oven, we have had success cooking in this oven, where in the past, with the other campers, we did not have success. The sink here, got some pork chops thawing out that we're gonna eat on here shortly. It's got this little doolally put across the top, dry some dishes, set them up here. That's pretty neat. Two different functions here. The storage underneath here, once again, goes way back there in the back. Three drawers here. The outlet here, that's another thing on the inside cabin here we're not tickled with, is there's not that many outlets. There is, for whatever reason, one underneath here. Not sure why. This table here lets down. This is where the 8-year-old has been sleeping. Let's see. These lights here are pretty neat, I guess. First time we've seen lights like that in our camper. This couch here is a trifold couch. It did not come with this couch. We wanted it to come with a trifold, but we just bought the camper and bought this on Amazon afterwards because the original couch was a jackknife couch, and that was not going to be big enough for two adults to sleep on. So when this comes out, it comes to about right here, and it's plenty of room for two adults, especially when we put a, you know, a foam topper on top of it. I think that's everything in here. It's got an air condition in here. I think we bypassed this because it has two different zones. It has zone 1 and zone 2 because there's two different air conditioners. Back here in the back room is another air conditioner. Let's see, it has a spot for you to put a TV back here in the back. We bought an extra one of these at the Target to put back here for extra storage because these really isn't all that much storage to keep your clothes in. Originally, when the camper, it came with a king size bed, and that bed flopped all the way over to the wall, so we got rid of that. And we bought two of these right here, little mattress covers, and put a foam top on top of it. And we have way more room to walk around back here, and we've been really pleased with it. It's got outlets on either side. It's got a USB port right there. It's got lights up here. And I've got no idea what that is right there. Please comment down below if you know what that is. It's not a magnet. I have no idea what to hook to it. These blinds right here, they go up, just straight up like that, but there's nothing to hook there. So I've got no idea what that is. So if you guys know, comment down below and let me know. And another closet there, same deal. Bought another one of these to have a little extra storage for clothes back here. And I think that's it. Overall, we're pleased with the camper. Has got some new things that we have not had in campers before, and some other things just getting used to, but in the long run, it's something to haul behind a vehicle and go travel the United States and spend time with family. If you got any questions about it, just put it down in the comments right here, and make sure you like and comment and subscribe to see what adventures we go on in this camper and all the fish that we can catch in that rod locker that I have. outside. Once again, thanks for watching, guys, and stay tuned. Who knows where we'll be next?